Hello, HP Touchpad users. Fantastic news. Developer James Sullins, aka JC Sullins in the forums, has put out yet another CyanogenMod 10 preview for the HP Touchpad, this time with all the sounds and microphone working. Bravo! Big thank you to him for this. Now, I gotta stress right away, this is an experimental preview build meant for limited testing only. This is great, it's got the sound working, but you're not gonna wanna make this your main ROM yet. I'd highly recommend making an Android backup of your current setup. It's a full system image. There'll be a link in the description to learn how to do that. And you'll basically be able to go and restore this. After playing around with this, testing this out, you can make an Android backup of this and flip-flop back between the two by restoring either setup. And this is really great to try, but there's going to be some major downsides, poor battery life, bad app compatibility, many bugs to work out. But what's really incredible about this is it not only shows us the CyanogenMod 10 has been worked on heavily, but it's near a point where it's going to be released and can be our regularly updated ROM. Hopefully there'll be nightly updates for CyanogenMod 10. I highly anticipate and look forward to that. Now, what's different about this version from the last one is we're going to need to do a full install. We can't just simply flash over the files. If you try to flash the files through Clockwork Mod regular update procedure with this ROM, you're going to have locking up and crashing of your device. It's going to be very unpleasant. So definitely going to want to make an Android backup. Now, I'm going to take you through the full installation process for this ROM, and then there'll be another video showing and demoing some of the features. But let's check it out. We're going to do a full install. I've got a great guide for you. First thing to do is go down to the description of the video and download this novacomfiles.zip file. Download that now, extract it, and open up that folder. Here is everything you're going to need to get started. Now, what I've done here is made a handy little how to install CyanogenMod the easy way guide. I'd recommend opening that up now. Now, this is going to cover every contingency from the very first-time user, first-time installer, to the more advanced users. All the links necessary are going to be included in the file, and you'll even be able to find your links for your ROMs in here, as well as the description of the video. So for first-time users, you're going to need to do Java installed from the link, and then you're going to need to install the Novacom files from the folder you just downloaded. Here's the Novacom Universal Installer, and that'll detect your operating system and install the appropriate files and folders for the software that interfaces with the HP Touchpad, the Palm Ink. Now, once we have that installed, we'll need all these handy little files put into this neat little package right here. We're going to open that up. What we'll need to do is navigate to our Palm Ink installation folder. The default for the Palm Ink will be located in C, Program Files, and Palm Ink. Open up this file now, and you'll need to copy and paste the files in the folder provided into this file. You can drag them, drop them, copy and paste them, as long as they're in here. These files will cover every contingency from installing CyanogenMod 7, 9, 10, and uninstalling as well. So it's very important that we get these in the folder before we go to the next step. Okay, Palm Ink's installed. We've got our appropriate files, the Acme Installer 3. We're ready to move on. Now, in the description of this video and in the README file, there will be links to all of the different ROMs. I put together a package for CyanogenMod 9 and 7, but today we're going to focus on 10. Now, 10 will be distributed into two packages, two downloads. One will be a package with all the CM install files, and then the other one will be the ROM file here. Download these two now, either from the README file or the description of the video. Once you've got them, extract it. Here's the CM install file for CyanogenMod 10, and then you'll have the ROM. And you'll need to copy and paste this ROM into the folder, and you'll have all four ready to go. Now, once we have all our ROM files ready to go, we're going to need to plug in our HP Touchpad. If it's the first time you plugged into the computer, you'll need to install drivers, wait for that, and possibly even reboot. More advanced users won't need to worry about that. You can just open it up. So open it up, navigate to your CM Tenderloin, which is what the HP Touchpad comes up to, your SD card, and you'll need to find the CM install folder. Now, if there isn't a CM install folder, you can create one or drag and drop the one you've created. Once you've got your file, you'll need the appropriate ROM files in this folder in order to install CyanogenMod 10 Preview, CyanogenMod 9, or CyanogenMod 7. All of these methods will be the same for each. Copy and paste the appropriate files into the folder on your HP Touchpad's SD card CM install folder. Once we have all these files on our HP touchpad, we'll be ready to move to the next step and install the ROM. So now I'm going to show you how to reboot the device and put it into USB mode.
To enter USB mode from Android, we'll simply need to hold the power button located on top of the device and select reboot. As soon as the screen goes dark, we'll want to hold the volume up button located here, the top, or the side top. It will bring the volume up at any other time, but while rebooting, it will enter the USB mode. Now hold the up button, volume up, till you see the USB symbol on the screen. We're now ready to install Cyanogen in Mod 10. So plug in your USB cable and make sure it's connected to the computer. In order to enter USB mode while using WebOS, we'll need to go to Settings. Next, we'll need to select Device Info. Here at the bottom, select Reset Options. And at the top, select Restart. As soon as the screen goes dark, we'll want to hold the volume up button. That's the volume up button here. Hold it down now as the screen goes dark. And when you see the USB symbol, make sure that your USB is plugged in and you'll be ready to install Cyanogen Mod.
Now that our HP touchpad is in USB mode, it's time to open up a command prompt and install Cyanogen Mod 10. The easiest way to do this if you're running Windows 7 is to go to the Start button and type in CMD into the search bar. You'll see it comes up there. You can click on it or press Enter. This gets us to the command prompt. Now, I know some people are going to be a little daunted by DOS, but you know what? I've made it nice and easy for you right here. We can simply copy and paste this part without the enter, of course, and paste it and press enter. No fuss, no muss. Just copy and paste and press enter on the following commands and it'll do everything for you. No need to worry yourself if you're not comfortable with this sort of interface. Just copy and paste, press enter. It's that simple and that easy. Coming up, we're going to have a few options, and that is pretty much the only point we're going to have to make a few decisions about what we're doing. Very easy. Now, we've basically changed our position, and we've gone from our regular default drive to the location of our Palm Inc. folder. And now we're going to access those files that we put into that folder earlier. Now, we have a couple options here. Now, let's talk about our options. So, if we're installing Cyanogen Mod 10, we'll need to use the Acme Installer 3. So we'll need to copy and paste this line. Now if we want to install Cyanogen Mod 9 or 7, we can use this line for the Acme Installer 2. And if we, in the event we want to uninstall, we simply get back to this point in the instructions and we copy and paste this line. And this will totally remove Cyanogen Mod any version. So if you have an event where you can't get rid of anything, you can't boot anything, you'll want to boot into USB mode by holding that volume up button and then just get back to this point and put this command in. This will remove everything and you can start over. Great news. But now in this event, we're going to install Cyanogen Mod 10. So what we're going to need to do is copy and paste the command to use the Acme Installer 3. Now the Acme Installer 2 and 3 are different. Acme Installer 3 will accommodate Cyanogen Mod 10 Jelly Bean by making a larger installation. So copy the appropriate line, in this instance the Acme Installer 3, and paste it in. Once we hit enter, the installation will begin on our device and we'll go over there and take a look.
Here we are in double penguin mode while we go through the methods of installation for Cyanogen Mod. It'll be the same no matter what version of Cyanogen Mod you're installing, except the Acme Installer version you select will be different. Even the uninstall will look very much like this too. For the installation, of course, you'll end up with Cyanogen Mod, and if you're doing the uninstall, it'll start up into WebOS. Can't stress enough how good it is to make an Android backup. I have a video about that. Check out the link in the description to learn about that. And it will just keep going and going and going. So there's nothing unusual about it taking a very long period of time. And always make sure you have a good charge on the battery before you attempt this. Because even though it's plugged in with the USB, it doesn't really get a lot of power like that. So it really drains the battery when you're installing the operating system. So make sure you have a good charge before you attempt it. Check out my video. I've got a video already up about demoing some of the features in this. I'll show you a little bit of it now as we enter, but you're going to want to check out my CyanogenMod 10 video here to see some features. I have videos on CyanogenMod 9 as well if you want to check out some of those and learn about some of the other builds of CyanogenMod. I have it going all the way back to CyanogenMod 7 on the HP touchpad, and you can try each and every version using these same installation methods. So once you've done this once, you'll know how to uninstall, you'll know how to install, you can do it from scratch. And what's really cool about this is you can actually upgrade. I'm upgrading. You can upgrade from CyanogenMod 7 to 9, and you can also upgrade from CyanogenMod 9 to 10, as you'll see here. Now you're about to witness the new CyanogenMod 10 boot animation. It's quite nice, I'm quite happy with it. Bit of a departure from Sid. Here we go, CyanogenMod. Thank you, CyanogenMod team. Thank you, JC Sullins, James Sullins. I can't wait to have a full version of CyanogenMod 10 on my HP touchpad. Now you'll notice that CyanogenMod 10 takes a little longer to boot. I've noticed it starts up a little more slowly. CyanogenMod 9 is a little more refined at this point. It just runs a little quicker. CyanogenMod 10 will eventually mature and be running quite well. And here we'll need to optimize all our applications before we can even start running Android. Just give it a little time. Here we are starting up Android CyanogenMod 10 for the first time on our HP touchpad. A JC Sullins preview build 2. I've had problems with the gallery stopping when I started, and it can be a little lagged. Just give it a moment, you can see things loading. Still loading. Widgets loading. And let's show you the proof. Here it is. Experimental Tenderloin for limited testing only. CyanogenMod 10 on the HP touchpad preview version 2. Please like the video and subscribe to see more updates and installation guides and everything Android related in the future. Thank you for watching.